He's a professor of infectious diseases at Northwestern University Feinberg School of Medicine. Good morning, doctor.
Good morning.
Why could that slow the decline in numbers?
I didn't hear you.
The new variant. Why would that impact the decline of numbers?
Oh yeah, no. The new variant is actually increasing the numbers, just based on the transmission. However, the disease is relatively mild, maybe 25 to 40% milder than the original one. But it is spreading, and it's going to compete with the original Omicron.
Some new numbers about long COVID and the vaccinated, and also boosters and how they're impacting people over the age of 50. Talk about those.
Oh yeah, but that's a good point, because the good thing about Omicron is that the vaccines actually work a little better than with Delta. Even in preventing infection, it's about 70% effective in preventing infection, like vaccines are supposed to, you know. And then if you're boosted, it's 95% effective against keeping people out of the hospital. I mean, that's really dramatic.
I wanted to ask you a question about an article I sent about red wine giving you some protection against COVID. Is that misreading cause and effect? Could it just be other reasons of wine drinkers that protects them?
Well, you know, the American public health people are pretty puritanical in terms of alcohol, and certainly abuse of alcohol is not good. But in this study with, I think it's 500,000 people, it's a Chinese study, they found that red wine has up to 17% effective, and it's actually related to how much you drink.
Yeah.
I mean, not to excess, but the more you drink, the more protection you had. 500,000 people, that's a powerful study. White wine champagne had about 5% protection, and unfortunately for beer drinkers and liquor drinkers, it worked in the other direction.
Okay.
There's something about red wine that does good for your heart and for COVID.
Before we get to the viewer questions, someone asked me about this who has little kids who are in daycare, and they keep, anytime there's a case, the kids have to get pulled out of daycare for 10 days because they can't be vaccinated. Do you see that going on forever? Is there a better system?
I don't think there's really a better system, but what will happen is there's going to be better tests, and then ultimately kids below 5 years of age are going by below 5 years of age are going to have a vaccine. So there will be a better system in that case. Yeah, it's so difficult in that age group now.
All right, viewer question. There is an upcoming car show at the Rosemont Convention Center called the World of Wheels. I abstained from attending and displaying my vehicle these last 2 years. Do you think it's safe to attend this venue this year?
I looked this up. This is, I think it's March 11th to 13th. And I predict, and I think models are showing the same thing, that the rates of COVID should be down by then. And if this person is vaccinated and boosted, should be okay.
All right. Next question. If you're vaccinated and boosted but attend an indoor event with no masks, how much time would you say to stay away from high-risk people just to be safe? 1 week, 2 weeks? It's hard to get tested in my area.
If it's hard to get tested, 10 days.
Okay.
All right, next question. If you've recently had COVID and you believe it was Omicron based on symptoms, how long are you considered to have increased antibodies?
Well, it's a little bit confusing because you can't really tell based on symptoms if you have Omicron, but in the United States, it's well over 90%. These people are... you just treat it just like any other COVID. 10 days is totally where you're free. And according to CDC guidelines, 5 days and then wear a mask.
All right, last question. Is the Delta variant completely gone?
No, the Delta variant is still kind of sneaking around, lurking around in there. When you look for it, if you actually go through the whole process of doing all the sequencing, somewhere between 0 and 10%.
All right. If you didn't get your question answered by Dr. Murphy, he answers them biweekly on Northwestern's Institute for Global Health Facebook page. You can submit questions via email or go to our Morning News Facebook page. Post